Gujarat Energy Research and Management Institute was inaugurated by the Honorable Narendra Modi and the chairman of the company, DJ Pandyan. A new day dawns. Sunlight connects the Earth's surface, impregnant with energy. Life would not be possible without it. At Jormi, we every day create a new world without jeopardizing tomorrow. Energy Research Management Institute, located in Gujarat, is pioneer in development and sustainability with the large facilities. Jormi sees to the entire planning, paperwork, construction, management, operations, and maintenance of the facilities. It is highly successful in petroleum, solar, and environmental development. Then and now, model can always sustain green energy.
We also undertake industrial training in all these three research wings. Jormi has created a new ventures recently, for example, establishment of data interpretation center in petroleum sector, e-course in environment sector, innovative consultancy to solar projects both in Gujarat and also in other states. Jormi is determined to be part of energy revolution in India. We now plan to train 10,000 solar technicians in India, who in turn will be part of the development of solar energy. It is a registered society started in 2004. It is working on all aspects of energy. Jormi is promoting academics, R&D and consultancy and also industrial training. In academic promotion, it has created the PDPU, the Petroleum University, and also associated with the recent creation of IIIT Vadodara.
The directions and the outcome of the journey gives academics, research and development, and consultancy and industrial training.
Introduction of summer intern program for the students from reputed institutions like IITs is another new initiation by Jormi.
We would go in the detailed explanation of Jormi's departments, which is highly professional, well organized, managed, and are successfully running. These are divided into three departments: Petroleum Research Wing, Environmental and Energy Efficiency Wing, and Solar Energy Wing.
Publication: we have crossed 70 research papers in peer-reviewed journals since 2010.
The Petroleum Research Wing inaugurated on September 7, 2013, and Petroleum Lab was inaugurated on October 14, 2013. There are projects and data regulated and are still regulating. Also, the company is coming up with brilliant energy data. Over 10 R&D projects are successfully completed.
Yeah, you are all aware that present day situation of this country's hydrocarbon production, the demand is increasing day by day and our supply is going down because the production of the hydrocarbons is less. Most of the Indian national oil companies and also the private companies are putting accelerated efforts to increase this production. And also, whatever the easy oil we have to find, we found it. Now, we have to search for oil in very difficult geological settings as well as in the logistically difficult areas. That's why we are putting our efforts into the deep water. Rigorous research and development in the fields of exploration for hydrocarbons. It is not possible to produce more and more oil. This has been realized by the government as well as by the private companies, and maximum emphasis is being put onto the R&D. Towards this direction, the Gujarat Energy Research Management has established a data interpretation center for carrying out research and development and focusing on finding out of the more oil, and also for geological and geophysical data analysis.
With the objective to serve as a center for excellence in research and development of increasingly efficient and well-adopted technologies to extract, upgrade, manage, and commercialize the hydrocarbon resources. In hydrocarbon research, the evaluation of two major parameters, the storage and transmission behavior of reservoir rocks, are important.
There is training which is provided to the students and industrial professionals like GSPC, IOC, and BPRL. The lab activities which are programmed include surface geochemical and microbial prospecting core analysis, hydrocarbon alternates, petrology, training, and geochemical data interpretation.
By the production prediction and the development of applicable techniques to increment the recovery. The exploration and exploitation of non-conventional hydrocarbon resources, especially the shale gas and coal bed methane and other alternates, are equally important for detailed R&D leading to a balanced and secured energy future. These preambles keep our team of scientists engaged along with the geochemical and microbial prospects to allocate the zones of hydrocarbon seepage, with efforts to develop synthetic combustion fuel while addressing the Gujarat Energy Research and Management Institute's mission statement toward the energy security.
We primarily focus on academics, fundamental and applied research, and consultancy services to the industry to solve their problems. Under academics, we have launched a unique course, which is an online short-term course on the design of wastewater treatment units. The course has been developed with a primary focus to develop the capacity building of the students, academicians, and the professionals in the field. In the first module, we got excellent response from the field and registered 65 participants. And now we have launched the second module.
The other core department is Environment and Energy Efficiency Research, which consists of environment audit and consultancy projects, development environment, software lab, and energy efficiency audit of industries. This department has in line projects of determination of hydraulic carrying capacity and quality modeling of creek passing through Surat Municipal Corporation, and environmental impact assessment for the development of Ranmal Lake for Jamnagar Municipal Corporation. The core vision of Environmental Software Laboratory is to consult services to the field consultants and the authorities, developed for the Indian conditions, developing the R&D projects for funding by pollution control authorities, Ministry of Environment Policy and Climate Change, DST and other government organizations, based on the applications of environmental.
years to ensure that the operation and maintenance goes on to be well. So we've done quite a lot of projects within Gujarat as well as outside Gujarat. And support the government in terms of doing their projects, doing their programs, policies, regulations. So that is one of our main mandates. There's a lot of insights that we get on how to, you know, run a program. So those learnings we are able to bring to the industry. So our second job becomes to support the industry, advising the industries, help in manufacturing. So these are the kind of, you know, works we do. Then the next major mandate for Germany is training and education. Then we help, if there are government companies or even private companies, we will help them develop either tenders or specifications to select an EPC contractor who is going to construct the power plant. We will put in the right contracts, like right guarantees and warranties. Considering the fact that half of our team is of scientists, but then the other half is engineers, also commercial professionals, because we not only do research, but we also get into implementation of projects. Right from the, you know, practical to the commercial structuring.
We also provide support to a lot of other areas of research, like wind energy research and geothermal energy research and solar thermal research as well. So we have started working for development of new type of windmill blades and realization of smart wind farm facilities for Gujarat, in realization of 10 megawatt facility for GSEC, which is up and commissioning now, same way for GPCL, and now we are also getting projects from outside Gujarat, from various government organizations and private entities. We have also certain flagship projects to our credit, like Gandhinagar 5 megawatt solar city program, smart grid pilot, microgrid facility. We also do rural electrification for coastal areas of Gujarat. So have a very strong characterization facility in form of semiconductor laboratory, where we do all our in-house research, and other researchers or scientists can also take advantage of our sophisticated facilities.
Materials like graphene, which is a very novel material, which is under the spotlight right now. It's called a magic material, and the reason is it is very strong, good mechanical characteristics. It is extremely transparent because it's a single atomic layer of graphite. And the third is it's extremely conducting, which you need for any electronic device. So we are exploring on how to utilize graphene into a solar cell design. We are also looking into indium gallium nitride, which is again a novel semiconductor, of how to make solar cells out of it, high efficiency solar cells. That's the basic fundamental research. On the applied side of research, we are looking at, you know, plant performance, because solar is new for India. There is a lot of learning which is coming out from these solar power plants as to, you know, whether to use thin films, whether to use polycrystalline silicon. So as a research institute, what we do is we look at plant performance.
Germany will always generate energy safely, cleanly, and efficiently.